This past week, I've been speaking about the timing that has been given to me of the seven trumpets that are recorded in the book of Revelations. I sent out a letter yesterday to people whom I know explaining this timing as well, because he will use the revealed timing of these trumpets to establish whom he has given his prophecy to. Yesterday, I was inspired to write in this letter that there could possibly be a gap before the destruction begins, as there was in other examples in Scripture, many other examples actually, like the recorded events of the flood. There was a 7-day gap there where Noah entered the ark, but before the flood waters were let loose. I said that I did not know for sure. I also said that more understanding is given each day, so I am a work in progress indeed. There is no doubt things are given in His timing and for a purpose, His purpose. This is the case with the sounding of the first trumpet. Early this morning, as the first day of unleavened bread drew near in my time zone, he showed me the meaning of the silence in heaven for the space of about a half an hour that's recorded in Revelation 8:1. And the verse says, "And when he had opened the seventh seal, there was silence in heaven about the space of a half an hour." I have thought that this was referring to a gap between the opening of the seventh seal and the blowing of the first trumpet. I think most people probably believe this. I posted a video a few weeks ago entitled The Two Witnesses, Part 1. In this video, an interesting thing happened just before 10 minutes into it. I spoke that we are in this time of silence at this time, or that time when I was speaking at, because I believe that we were. When I spoke this, the video did not advance with the audio for 12 seconds. I re-recorded and I remade the PowerPoint of this video, and I reconverted to video, and I re-uploaded it to YouTube, but the defect in the video persisted. I was dumbfounded by this. This made me think that maybe I was wrong about this being the period of time, and considered redoing the video without this statement. But I wanted to finish part two, and I'd spent so much time trying to make part one work with that, so I kept moving forward. I'm sorry for this. This was a sliver of that stiff neck attitude that I must fight, keep fighting against and dying to. It is exciting every time that I'm given new understanding, but I also am hoping that it will be the last time that I'm wrong about something. But this is not reality until I'm out of this flesh. The possibility of being wrong about anything is also incentive to fight to learn everything that is true, and incentive to dismiss everything that is false. That's why we have to be diligent and just keep fighting to leave what we've been taught by men. Sometimes it is indeed hard to dismiss preconceived ideas, but doing so keeps us from being able to see the truth. So we just have to fight against all understanding that we've been given from other sources. The truth is, this verse is saying that after the seventh seal was opened, there is a time period where the angel will step forward to blow the first trumpet, but it will not sound for this period of time. This period of time is a statement being made to you by your Creator. It is a period of a half a week, which is 3.5 days, reflecting the period of time that his son was killed until he was resurrected. So indeed, the trumpet was going to blow on the Passover, as I was given understanding. He was in the tomb for 3 days and 3 nights, but he was dead for 3.5 days, just as his other witness will be dead for 3.5 days in July of 2012. This period of 84 hours began at the timing of Yeshua's death on the 14th day of the first month, which was in mid-afternoon of the 18th day of April this year, as measured by Jerusalem time. This places the beginning of the blowing of the first trumpet between approximately 3 a.m. and 7 a.m. Jerusalem time on the 21st day of April, and the way that man keeps track of time. This is the corresponding timing of Yeshua's resurrection, not on Easter Sunday, as most who profess his name celebrate this event. He is using this timing as a statement against all that worships him falsely. Jerusalem is 7 hours different from New York, so if my calculations are correct, figuring the time zones, the first trumpet will be beginning to blow anywhere from approximately 8 p.m. on the 20th day of April to midnight New York time, so buckle up. His desire is that you will turn from your ways and turn to his instructions, so that he can make you in his image, so that you can become his child and live forever in his family. His word was sent for this purpose. Lay hold of what he is offering you and embrace his deliverance into a new era of time out of the coming tribulation. And when this new era of time, when he will show you his ways and pour out his spirit on all flesh, it is going to be incredible to live in this era.